We can now have a look at the methods of conversion. You can convert a query immediately to results by using these methods. Let us see them one by one. The first method is list. Convert the result into list. List is a collection, and list is a collection of variable size to which you can add or remove elements as required. This is one thing. And how you can iterate over each? You can write for each type k in list. List is the identifier for the list. K is a variable for the for each loop, and t is the type of elements contained in the list. So you can convert a query into a list immediately by writing code like this. Where q is ls.select. We are taking an example where we are taking a projection of a dynamic. So we are writing select. This is select is taking place on a collection of C order data, and the result of that select is a dynamic collection. So we are writing a collection of dynamics. X goes to new, X dot invoice to X dot amount. So this returns an anonymous, and it is finally placed into a dynamic. And dot to list. If you write dot to list dynamic, then whatever the result was coming here, that is immediately changed into a list, and execution occurs at this point. And then we are using for each loop, for each where n and q. And since n is a dynamic, we can use n dot invoice to n dot amount. On similar lines, we can use the toArray method to get the result in the form of an array. We are writing where q is equal to ls.select. Select is operating on a collection of type C order data. The end result is a dynamic. And how is it obtained? We are writing x goes to new, x.invoice to x.amount. So the end result will be, if executed, the end result will be a collection of dynamic objects. And we can immediately convert this query into an array by writing dot to array. So this will result in an array of dynamics. And an array is always of fixed size. So if you want an array, you can write the function called toArray here. For each where n and q, then you are executing this using a for each loop to iterate over the whole of the array. List and array are similar, but what is a dictionary? The storage inside dictionary is in a bit roundabout manner. Consider this is a dictionary. Dictionary D. This dictionary, the objective of the dictionary is to store objects. But instead of directly storing the objects, it stores objects of key value pair struct. Key value pair is a struct. It immediately holds objects of key value pair. And this object in turn has two properties. One is key and the other is value. And this key contains that property out of the value of the entire object which you assign as the key. So for example, you are having an object having three properties P1, P2 and P3.